Can anyone remember the film Haunted Mansion and how bad that was? The same reason for why that sucks so bad is pretty much the same reason why this one sucks. It's not that it didn't make an attempt to make a great film, it's that there was one key feature or two that brought it down. In Haunted Mansion, it was Bill Murray. Here, it was the main characters. Pretty much all seven of them, with the exception of the killer, of course. They call him the Reeker, they call him the Death Valley Drifter, what have you. Now, I would have shown you the trailer in this, but the trailer revealed too much, and I didn't want to do that, so I decided to go with this short clip from the beginning. Now, this was a hard one to rate because it had a really good story, it had a really good plot, and the acting of the supporting characters and the special effects were good as well, but the main problem was bad acting and bad dialogue on the part of the main characters. Otherwise, I could have probably really enjoyed this more. I truly enjoyed the plot, but you have to get past the acting and interaction between the characters and the dialogue, which at times is bad, and they do that same thing where they go and talk about feelings and relationships in the middle of a horror film. You don't do that! You shouldn't do that! It's so stupid when people do that. I prefer the kills more. And that's what you really go for in a horror film. You go for the kills, you go for the thrills. And sometimes you even go to laugh. In some cases, you may even do that in this. But really, this could have been better. I give it a 2.25 out of 5 because I wanted to give it a 3, but it just the acting and the fact it had some twists at the end, more than one, and the last one didn't follow through like I would have liked. So I didn't like that. Now, this has a related film, not a prequel or a sequel, but it's apparently another Reeker film that you might want to look into. But that's my rating. Have a good night.